Hey, it's Shannon from iHeartRadio Canada, joined by Carrie Underwood. Carrie, congratulations on my gift. Thank you so much for this gift. It brings me right back to Christmas Eve at church. I love it.
That's good. Yeah, when we were making my gift, we just wanted it to be just all of the things that are good about Christmas. And so many songs are on there that I've literally been singing for my whole life. We went in to see if we could write some new ones, to see if we could add anything to the ever-growing catalog of Christmas music. And yeah, it was so nice to be able to make this album in the middle of this year and go in and sing these songs that I love so much.
Yeah. What made you want to go with the title, My Gift?
Well, it kind of came from Little Drummer Boy. It's hard to name an album. I'll preface that way. It's like naming your child and you're like, oh, this is going to be with me for the rest of my life. But I started thinking about the songs that were important. And I love that song so much. I love the story behind it. I love that there's a little boy. All he had was a gift that he had been given from God. The thing that he loved to do, which was play the drums. He wanted to give that back to Jesus. And I kind of feel like me getting to sing, it's the thing that I just feel the most joy doing. Whether it's on stage, in a studio, or walking around my house singing, it just makes my heart happy. And that is a gift that I get to experience. So I wanted to give that back to Jesus.
Yeah, that's so great. And speaking of Little Drummer Boy, we have to talk about the real star of this album, right? Isaiah. It's so exciting. How did you first approach him about it? How did that conversation come up?
Well, I will say, I'm like, this is his album. I'm just singing.
Yeah.
You know? I went into the studio and I recorded that song by myself. And in my head, I could just always hear his voice and see him singing it. Because that's so his personality. He will make you things and bring you things. And he wants to give. And he's such a sweet, kind-hearted little boy. I could see him doing that. You know, oh, I'm going to play Jesus a song. So I asked him, you know, would you like to go sing with mommy in the studio? He got so excited. That day he like dressed himself. He dressed up. He wore like a button-up shirt and jeans. And he hates wearing jeans. So I walked downstairs. I was like, look at you all dressed up, all spiffy. And he was like, I'm singing for Jesus today. So I wanted to dress up. And we went there and I was like, I don't know what's going to happen. He could get shy. He could just say, I don't want to do this anymore. But he sang his little heart out and he sang it from his heart. Like he doesn't know charts. He doesn't know sales. He doesn't know album. He doesn't know any of that stuff. He just knows that it makes him happy. So he sang and it was just, oh, the sweetest thing.
Yeah, that's so nice. And I feel like so many parents too, like they have photos and videos of their kids growing up, and now you get to have this like keepsake. So what does that mean to you to be able to hold on to this forever?
I mean, I thought about that so many times while we were making, you know, that song. When he's like older and his voice is all dude-like, I'm still going to have that, you know, I'm still going to have, you know, this moment in time captured on video. We had a camera there too, you know, video, audio. I will have that forever. And it as a mom, it just makes me super, super happy.
Totally. If he comes to you when he's older and says like, Mom, I want to do this too. I want to get into the music industry. What kind of advice do you think that you would give to him with him going into that?
I mean, no matter what he does, we're, you know, going to be supportive, and whatever he ends up doing, I just want him to give it his all. I just want him to work hard. I don't know if music will be where he wants to be, but I would totally support that as long as he just gives it his all.
Totally. And I know Jacob's so young too, but do you see that passion for music with him as well?
He will sing like pum, pum, rum, pum, pum, rum, rum, rum. Like he'll kind of sing that. And he'll sing Hallelujah. He likes that one. Doesn't quite come out as Hallelujah. But you know, that's what he's singing. So I feel like the fact that he can sing something and I'm like, I know what that is a good sign.
Nice. So he'll be on the next album.
Maybe. Yeah.
We'll see. That's so exciting. How is it for you to create an original Christmas song? Do you find it's a lot more different or challenging than compared to just writing a regular song for an album?
I mean, it is, because there are just so many incredible Christmas songs. And when you write something like that, and we were writing on Zoom this time because we couldn't all be together. So that was a whole other level of, you know, a monkey wrench thrown into things because there's like a delay, and it's not ideal to write a song with people over the internet, over your cameras. We just wanted to add something. And in the case of things like Sweet Baby Jesus, I mean, my mom like called me crying about that one. And she's like, is that an old song? And I was like, no, but the fact that you would even ask that, I'm like, okay, I feel really great about this song because you thought it was something that had been around. It sounded familiar, which was great.
Totally. I had that same thought with that one because I kind of second guessed you. I was like, wait, is this an original or is this like a Christmas song that I just haven't heard before? So yeah, I can totally see that.
Yeah. And I, you know, that's the hope too. You want people years from now. And that's the great thing about Christmas music. It's like people find a song and they want to re-record it because it meant something to them like when they were growing up with it. So who knows? And in a decade or so, people might cover things. And that's such a cool thought.
Yeah, I can see that for Hallelujah as well. That's incredible, especially like for duets and things like that. How was it working with John?
It was so great. I mean, they sent us that song and I just thought it was beautiful and asked if I wanted to sing it. Would he want to sing it with me? And he said yes. And again, it wasn't ideal because we weren't in the same room. He's in LA and I'm in Nashville, and we just had to make it work with the year that we have. So it was a different way of recording, but I'm so proud of us that we managed to go through with it and make it sound, hopefully it sounds like we were in the same room together.
Oh, it definitely sounds like you're in the same room together. That's like the power of the internet, though. At least there's that, right?
Well, at least, you know, and without that, we wouldn't have gotten to make this album. So it's a learning curve, but I feel like we were all just determined to, you know, keep moving forward, and we wanted to make this album. We didn't want it to be like, oh man, we have, you know, this 2020 is the way it is. We didn't want to stop working on it.
Yeah, that's so true. I know that you were a big fan of Christmas growing up. Do you have a favorite Christmas tradition that you had with your family?
I don't know if we have. We did when we were kids. We would go down to the nursing home with fruit that we had put in little paper bags and pass out fruit and sing Christmas carols up and down the halls and try to bring some Christmas cheer. But I think my favorite things about Christmas was just the familiarity of all of it. Like we had the same stockings year after year. We had the same ornaments year after year. There were so many things that you could just count on year after year. And I feel like now that I still have those records that we would listen to. And I still have like a few of the things that like my mom had. It was just the familiarity and thinking about that for my kids. It's like, no matter what, like we will still have these pillar things, even if we have a crazy year to deal with, we have that heart and that familiarity.
Yeah. And now you can like add My Gift as like an album that you can listen to year after year, right?
Hopefully people do that. It gets a little tricky when I listen to myself, but I'll listen to Little Drummer Boy all day long because I want to hear his sweet little voice.
Will you not listen to your own albums?
I do when I am approving things and listening to things, you know, for that reason. But I don't know, when you're just like, oh yeah, I do this for a living. Like, I don't know, it gets a little strange. And I don't want people to like walk into my house and be like, oh my gosh, she's listening to herself.
Amazing. Congratulations on the Christmas special as well. It was so gorgeous. Those dresses were incredible. Did you get to keep the dresses? Are those now you just wear them around the house?
No, I did not. There's only one of each of those, and they're very grand. So if I had them in my closet, they would take up all of my closet. So I wear them and return them, give them back to the designers. But I'm lucky that I get to borrow such fabulous things and pretend I'm a Christmas princess for a little while.
Totally. Okay. So I feel like there's two types of people. I feel like there's the people that either dress up their pets for Christmas and those that don't. Which side are you on?
I will put the outfits on them for the picture and then take them off. I used to dress, I have a rat terrier who's now almost 15 years old. I used to kind of put him in clothes every once in a while, like little t-shirts. But then as we got older, I stopped doing that. But I will put them, have our like entire family in matching Christmas pajamas, and they do have their own pajamas.
That's good. Do they get their own stockings as well?
they collectively share a stocking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I have one husband, kids, and then there's a dog one.
Nice. That's good. Don't spoil them too much.
I know.
That's good. Carrie, thank you so much for taking the time. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.